väga hea meel rääkida Telia Eesti juhi Robert Pajosega, kes on töötanud väga mitmes kultuuris, Brasiilias, Venemaal, no väga-väga mitmes kultuuris. Eesti on talle, ma arvan, võib-olla isegi 10. Koht, kus töötada. It's really a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
So, you came to work here in Estonia from Brazil. How is it very dull or boring to work here in Estonia? Is it very, very different culture when comparing to Brazil? No?
I was to this all employee meeting or all employee party with all the Telia employees, and it was really like being back in Latin America again. So I would say that when Estonians want to party, it is really like being back in Brazil again.
Really? Why? Because we are Estonians, we are thinking that we are maybe shy and we are not very talkative and maybe a little bit introverted, but no.
No, you
your
party
experience,
really well.
Your experience is not that.
Not so, no.
Okay. But if you can pick one country who is not that well this digital situation, what would it be?
I think you can pick any country in Latin America and Central America. They have a lot to learn from Estonia. I took this example actually in my speech today. I was talking a little bit about the Colombian ICT minister, that he has been learning very much about how e-government works here in Estonia, and he has taken it into the transformation of that he is trying to do with the Ministry of Communication, but also with the government in Colombia.
You were talking about how to hire a bodyguard in Colombia. What is that? Is it very hard thing to do?
Your thinking is quite. I mean, when I was trying to hire a bodyguard in Colombia, you start to think about what are normal questions that you're asking a person that you would like to hire. So it's what is your background? What are your achievements so far? And with a bodyguard, you have to start asking different questions. Do you have a weapons license? Are you skilled in shooting? Have you? So it is, of course, a different situation. And for me, I only done it once, and I don't think I'm going to do it again, to interview and find a bodyguard.
It is very interesting. I always wonder when people are switching their workplaces, not only the workplaces, but the states and countries. Why are you doing that? Is it okay? Is it comfortable to move, really, to move Russia to Brazil, from Brazil to Estonia? How are you doing this?
If you want to learn a culture in a country, just visiting for 1 or 2 weeks is not enough. You will never know how it is to open a bank account. You will not know how to drive a car in that country, navigate, etc. There's so many cultural things that you miss by not living in a country. So I think that's the drive. I've always been curious to live in a different country and see how it really is. And I've been fortunate then to have a job that brought me to different places in the world. And it's really fun.
Okay. What are the interesting things here in Estonia? Maybe we are not noticing ourselves. We have some, I don't know, something very unique comparing to other countries. What do you think?
First you have the proximity to very big markets around Europe. Then you have a very educated class. I mean, some of the best schools I hear are here in Estonia, so it's not a surprise that it's very easy to find good engineers, although there's a big competition between those. So I think there's a lot in Estonia that is something to cherish and to take care of.
What do you think about hiring people from abroad? I understand that we have a real lack of IT people might be willing to work in technology companies and in digital field. What do you think?
But Estonia is already doing that. So there are engineers coming if you have skills, and also the universities, they have programs for foreigners, etc. So I think that Estonia is quite open for business.
Yeah, it's inevitable to have people from abroad. Have you considered where to go next, or when you are at place, you know, for example, here in Estonia, you are not thinking where to go next?
No. We never did. Sometimes when we didn't have kids, we say, okay, now we've been here for 2.5 years. Usually we get moved after that time. That's just been the cycle. So when my wife and I had been married for 10 years, we had already completed 7 physical moves.
Okay.
So I think it is a little bit in the genes. Maybe we're a little bit of gypsies.
Okay. But when you were working in Russia, Russia is very, well, we also, in Estonia is no Russian language and etc. Was it very different from Estonia to work there? In Russia, I mean.
From Estonia? It's been a while since I worked in Russia, so...
Well, it doesn't matter when you have company, and then you hire people, maybe it's not that different, I don't know.
If you have been, I think it is a little bit the same. I mean, you have, if you have a friend in Estonia, you have it for a lifetime. The same thing in Russia. And I was arriving to St. Petersburg and became the office manager at my previous company in St. Petersburg. And I was there for 3 days and I stepped out in the street and I ran into an old friend of mine. And he was so hysterically angry with me that I had been arriving to St. Petersburg without letting him know. Of course, we made up and we can explain that I have only been there for 3 days, and so please forgive me, I haven't given you a call. But he was really, really mad. So friendship is very important, I think, in all countries, but very much so in Russia.
It's hard to have friends when you are moving that much, like a gypsy.
No.
Or the digital era is helping.
Exactly.
Maybe you're Skyping with them.
But you also have to have the discipline to sometimes give a call to your friends in Brazil and Colombia and keeping in touch. That's I think I do that really well.
How big fan of the technologies are you? Are you using, I don't know, different apps and things and...
I'm a normal user. I don't think I'm extreme in any case. I think when I was younger, I was much more investigating, testing new things. Now I go, I think, with the flow, and maybe even a follower, I'm afraid. But I like to read about technology. It's always, if I have a chance, I do that.
Okay.
Now 5G, for instance, is something that is really interesting to see what are the applications and how can we use it.
What is your biggest challenge in Telia?
There are so many things I would like to do, but I think if you look inside Telia, it's the transformation of Telia from inside, making sure that we have better efficiencies of our platforms and the way that we take products to the market. So I think this is the one challenge. External, I think we're doing quite well, but we can do maybe better when it comes to developing TV, developing our IT services, being a better partner to our B2B customers. So there's, I think there's a few things that we can do better, yes.
So you are planning to stay for how many years then? 2, 3, 4?
I don't, why can't I stay forever? I don't know.
Of course. Hospitality is our middle name here in Estonia. We like frenzy.
No, but we have no plans of moving. So, and me and my wife, and we also taught our kids that when we are in a place, we are there to stay. So, in Swedish, we say we take the tent sticks and we hit them really hard into the ground. And I think this is the only way to live, because if you are in a temporary mode, then you're always ready for the next move. So, and then you don't live. Then you are in a transition period, and then you never, it's not the state that I would like to bring my family into. So we are now here until we leave somewhere, but that might be very far off.
Okay, thank you for being here.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.